Magandang gabi po, Jagians. Good evening to everyone. Welcome to our Holy Week Reflections. Starting tonight until Saturday night, we're gonna take a look on the last words of our champion, which is our Lord Jesus Christ. So, pinangalanan po natin to, the title of our 7 days, 4 days reflection is The Champ. Reflection on the 7 final words of the champion. And to start this reflection or meditation, we will begin with the first word of our Lord Jesus Christ in his sufferings. When Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, they don't know what they are doing." The first word of the champion is forgive them. Forgiving or forgive them is our words, words in pain. Obviously, no, si Jesus po, our Lord Jesus Christ, during the sufferings, during crucifixion, he is in pain. Makita po natin sa Luke 23:34, then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them. They don't know what they are doing." Bago ko po ituloy, this is a story of forgiveness. It happened in the India. Si Tariq Kamisa po, a boy or a man, who, a delivery man or delivery boy, who was delivering a pizza. When a 15-year-old boy approached him, tried to rob him off. So, ang ginawa nung boy na yon, gustong kunin o nakawin yung pizza niya. So, ang ginawa ni Tariq Kamisa ay nag-refuse na ibigay yung kanyang gamit o yung pizza na hawak niya. So, pangalan po ng boy is si Tony Hicks. So, naglaban po ng laban, nag-agawan po sila. And Tony Hicks, the boy, pulled out a gun and shot Tariq, killing him. So in short po, napatay po ng batang ito si Tariq Kamisa. And Tony Hicks was caught and brought to trial. He was just 15 years old. He was imprisoned for 25 years. And si Tariq Kamisa po, Tariq Kamisa's father was broken-hearted. Sobrang nasaktan siya ng pagkamatay ng kanyang anak. So it left him feeling depressed and suicidal. Then came the day when Tony Hicks' grandfather, yung lolo po nung batang nakulong, asked to meet with the father. Sabi nung lolo nung batang nakulong, gusto niyang makipag-meet o makipagkita para mag-offer ng condolences. Kasi po si Tony Hicks po ay pinalaki ng kanyang lolo. So Tony Hicks also asked for forgiveness. Yung bata mismo humingi din siya ng tawad. Ang 15 years old po siya nung time na yon, at pinagdudusahan niya po yung kanyang ginawa for 25 years of imprisonment. The question is, ano kaya yung response ni Tariq Kamisa, ng father ni Tariq Kamisa, ano kaya yung response niya? Mamaya ko po itutuloy kung ano ang response ng tatay. To be continued. Okay? Abangan ang susunod na kabanata. First stage to becoming a champion is letting go of hurts. Ang first stage po para maging champion or maging matagumpay ang isang tao, we need to let go of hurts and pains. Forgive as often as you need. Ito po yung sikreto, unang-unang sikreto po ng ating Panginoong Yesus. You know, in this fight called life, we cannot avoid pains, hurts, and offenses. Hindi po talaga natin maiiwasan yung may makasakit sa atin, ma-offend tayo. It will always come, whether sinasadya yan o hindi sinasadya. Usually, it comes from the closest people we have, the closest person or the most trusted people we have. Let's go to sports. Like to a boxing champion. pains, hurts, and offenses are blow of life. Katulad po ni Manny Pacquiao, bilang boxer, ang pains and hurts po ay part na ng buhay niya. But these painful moments are training ground or training arena. A good boxing coach po intentionally throw punches to his trainee in order to develop stronger muscles and resistance to the blows and punches of the opponents. Kaya po, during the time of training po ni Manny Pacquiao, bago siya lumaban, 3 to 6 months of his fight, tinitraining po siya ni Fred Roach. Napapanood ko po yung kanyang mga trainings at intentionally talagang sinusuntok siya ng sinusuntok sa chan, sa tagiliran, para ma-develop po yung kanyang muscles and resistance sa mga suntok. So learning to catch punches increases your tolerance to pain and strengthen your defense. So ganun ang nangyari kay Manny Pacquiao. Nasanay na siya sa mga suntok, sa mga palo, sa pain. At ito ang nakapagpalakas sa kanya sa kanyang depensa. Ganun din naman po sa science, no? In like to a healthy body, sa ating pangangatawan naman, an attack of a virus to a body system, it develops or increases a greater antibodies against bacteria and viruses. Pag tayo po ay pinasok ng virus, nagde-develop naman po, may ganun po ang pagkaka-design sa atin ng Lord, yung sa katawan natin. Pag inatake po tayo ng virus, ng bacteria, alien po yan sa katawan natin. So our antibodies, kumikilos po sila. Nag-i-increase po yung ating antibodies para labanan ang bacteria at viruses. Kaya po nagkakaroon din po tayo ng lagnat. So, yung immune system po natin will gonna fight the attack of bacteria, viruses, and fungi that has a harmful effect in our body. You know, forgiveness boosts your spiritual immune system. Ang forgiveness po ay pampalakas ng ating spiritual immune system. It resists and protects us from the sicknesses and diseases like cancer of bitterness, heart attack of loneliness, diarrhea of depression, diarrhea of loss, no? Disease of depression, and the high blood pressure of resentment. Kaya po, ang forgiveness, it's very important na ito po ay maging lifestyle natin kasi offenses and hurts comes talaga, it always comes to us. Do you know that once you forgive, your body produces more dopamine? Now, it's a chemical associated with mood elevation in the brain. Kapag po talaga pala tayo nagpatawad, ang body po natin ay nagpo-produce ng chemical, happy chemicals sa body natin. It is one of the feel-good chemicals in our body. And it plays a vital role in how happy we feel. So, ang effect po ng dopamine na ito, it affects our movement, our memory, and focus. So, importante pala yon. Pag nag-forgive ka, nagre-release tayo ng dopamine sa ating katawan. Meaning, when you release forgiveness, your body produces happy chemicals called dopamine, which energizes your body, enhances your memory, it brings you mental health, and set your mind and help you to focus. So, pag galit ka at masama ang loob mo, di ba, hindi ka makatulog, di ka makapag-isip, hindi ka makapag-isip ng mabuti, at di ka rin makatrabaho ng maayos. Ang taong hindi nagpapatawad ay balisa. So katulad pa, let us learn from a child. Children are the happiest people in the world. They are the happiest being on earth. Why? Because they easily forgive. It would be harder to advance or achieve more when we take hold of something against someone. Mahirap po na mag-advance at mag-achieve greater Kapag po tayo laging may hinanakit o hinahawakang galit laban sa ibang tao. Kaya nga, we also attend encounters para doon pa lang ay makita po natin ang source of forgiveness and we can also learn how to forgive other people. So, why Jesus forgives while it hurts? Bakit nagpatawad si Jesus habang nasasaktan siya? You know, hurts, pains, and offenses are unavoidable. Hindi po yan maiiwasan. During the time of his suffering, Jesus was accused, beaten, crucified, stricken, rejected. The first word uttered from his mouth was the powerful words, "Father, forgive them." Father, forgive them. Many times, which according to the scholars, Jesus repeatedly cried out these words. Paulit-ulit po niya sinasabi yon habang pinapako siya, habang pinapalo siya, habang minumura siya at tinutuya siya. Paulit-ulit pong sinasabi ng ating Panginoong Hesus, "Ama, patawarin mo po sila." And his body was able to carry the cross till he was hung on the cross. Kaya yung katawan po niya ay na-boost up at nakayanan niya pong ibuhatin ang krus hanggang siya ay ipako sa krus. And this is the power of forgiveness, that every time he shouted these words, his body is boosted up to fight. His energy is prolonged. Nothing depleted his emotion nor caused his will to give up. Kaya paulit-ulit na sinasabi niya, "Ama, patawarin mo po sila. Ama, patawarin mo po sila." Nag-re-release siya ng kapatawaran habang nasasaktan siya. At ang katawan niya po ay nakakalaban po sa lahat ng mga pains and sufferings and rejections, mockery na ibinigay po sa kanya ng tao. And his whole being was focused in finishing the fight. Kaya hindi po tayo magtataka na napakahaba po ng energy, ng stamina ng ating Panginoong Jesus during the crucifixion. And his mind was focused in finishing the fight. Na nasa isip niya po, walang pwedeng makapagpatigil sa kanya sa para tapusin yung work of redemption. He was focused. Alam niyo po, I learned that a forgiving person is a focused person. While the hammer was pounding the nails through his hands and feet, habang binabaon po ng martilyo ang pako sa kanyang paa at kamay, Jesus was shouting, "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." Every time it hurts, Jesus shouted, "Father, forgive them." Tuwing masasaktan po siya, ang isinisigaw niya po, "Ama, patawarin mo po sila." The Jesus we reject in our generation, the Jesus we mock in our generation is the one interceding to us right now for all of us that the Father will forgive us. Ganun po tayo kamahal ng Panginoong Jesus. Until today, He is interceding in behalf of us that all our sins may be forgiven. And Peter, one day Peter asked him about forgiveness. Sabi ni Peter kay Jesus, "Lord, how many times should I forgive someone who sinned against me?" Medyo mayabang pa dating ni Peter. Sabi niya, "Is it 7 times 7? Up to 7 times? Up to 7 times? Sabi ni Jesus, Jesus replied, "Not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Meaning, we need to forgive in a week with more than every hour a day. We need to forgive. Every time you hurt, every time hurts, every time pains and offenses come, forgive. When it hurts, forgive. No need to wait to cease or to stop the pain. While it is hurting, you can forgive. Jesus set an example. When it is hurting, He forgives. There are three powerful things we could learn from the forgiveness of Jesus. Number one, God will forgive us. God will forgive us. Future tense, past tense, or future tense, He will forgive us. Even your future offenses against God, the Lord will forgive you. The Lord will forgive us. Though we hurt Him many times, madalas po nasasaktan natin ang Panginoon. When we come and repent, He will forgive us. For forgiveness is promised. Ipinangako po ng Panginoon sa atin ang kapatawaran. In 1 John 1:9, the Lord said, the beloved said, confess your sins and He is faithful. If you confess your sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us from all our unrighteousness. So, ang Diyos po ay willing anytime na tayo po ay patawarin. Pangalawa, we can also forgive ourselves. Pwede po natin patawarin ang ating sarili. Since God made a way to restore us back through forgiveness, we also have the power to forgive ourselves, our own mistakes. Kailangan po matuto din tayong patawarin natin yung ating mga sariling pagkakamali at kasalanan. Since pinatawad ka na ng Diyos, patawarin mo na rin ang sarili mo. We need to set ourselves free from the chains of the past. Kung pinatawad ka na ni Lord, patawarin mo na rin ang sarili mo. So you can advance and you can move on. And number three, we can also forgive others. Ibig sabihin po, there is a wonderful privilege that has given to all of us, and that is to forgive others. Though we are also offender, lahat tayo offender, the Lord has given us the power to forgive others. Now, we are learning from the champion, who is Jesus Christ. A champion does not take hold of anything. A champion does not take hold any offenses and hurts that could hinder him or slow him down in the fight. Yan ang sekreto po ng champion. Tinatapon niya lahat ng makakapagpabigat. Sineset aside niya at tinatanggal niya ang lahat ng makakapag-set aside para siya manalo sa laban. Sabi po sa Hebrews chapter 12 verses 1 to 2, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily slow us down. Itapon natin lahat ng makakahadlang at makakapagpabagal sa ating pagtatapos ng laban. Run with endurance the race that God has set before us. We do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus. So, yung ating pagtakbo ay andun po yung ating endurance o yung determination natin para matapos po natin yung laban. Ginagawa po natin yan by keeping our eyes or fixing our eyes on Jesus. Kay Jesus ka lang, sa Diyos ka lang tumingin. Not to the left, not to the right. Not sa mga offenses or hurts or pains. Kay Jesus lang. Jesus is the champion. Sabi po sa Hebrews, keeping your eyes, fixing your eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. Because of the joy awaiting Him, He endured the cross, disregarding its shame. Jesus Himself, the champion of heaven, our champion, He endured the cross, He disregarded all the shame. Idinisregard niya lahat ng mga kahihiyan, lahat ng mga mockeries, lahat ng mga accusation, lahat ng mga pains and hurts of the cross in order to finish the fight. Now, He is seated in the place of honor beside God's throne. Amen. Like Jesus, who is not spared from offenses. Katulad ni Jesus, hindi siya na-spare sa mga offenses. He is not spared from pains and hurts. Jesus did not resist them. The mockery, the strike, the rejections, Every punches make him a stronger fighter. Yung mga naranasan niya, yung mga pains and rejections, it makes him a better person. It makes him a better fighter. It makes him a stronger fighter. Strong enough to forgive. That's why his opponent, Satan, has no hold of him. Why? Because during the hurts and the pains, he releases forgiveness. Jesus is focused to finish and win the fight. In order for you to be a champion here on earth and to the eternal life, you need to forgive so that the devil will not take hold anything in your life and you will win the fight. And let us continue about the story of Tony Hicks. Si Tony Hicks, yung batang nakulong, he asked for forgiveness. And yung lolo niya wanted to meet the family and give condolences to Tariq Kamisa's father. And that during the time, he was so depressed. Yung tatay po, sobrang depressed, suicidal na siya. And you know what he considered in his life, dun sa tatay po, ang kinonsider ng tatay, he decided to go down to the road of forgiveness. He met the grandfather of Tony Hicks. Nakipagtagpo siya. He saw that they are victims at both ends of the gun. Parehas po silang biktima. And he's decided, you know what happened after releasing forgiveness? He decided to build a foundation in his son's name and wanted it to be focused on preventing violence. Dahil sa pag-release niya ng forgiveness, nakapag-focus siya, nakapag-accomplish siya ng isang foundation na kung saan makakapag-encourage at makakapag-educate sa mga young people in order to prevent violence. So ang ginawa po ng father ni Tariq, tinawagan niya yung lolo ni Tony Hicks and asked for his help. And now, you know what? Magkasama na po sila sa foundation. And over 10 years now, they have been going around schools talking to children about choices, revenge, and forgiveness. The father and the grandfather is now together doing the ministry to the children, educating them, and teaching them forgiveness. Tariq grandfather's reason, alam niyo kung anong Tariq's father reason is this. It is natural to want revenge. Kapag nasaktan ka, naturally, you want to revenge. Gusto mong gumante. Pero ang tanong, sabi niya, maibabalik kaya yung buhay ng anak ko kung gaganti ako? So what he did, instead of revenge, he said, I choose forgiveness and reach out to Tony's grandfather. The count reads is this. Alam nyo, nag-develop ito ng unity, love, and amazing bond between the family of Tariq and Tony Hicks. It is now 10 years into his 25-year sentence. Nasa loob po ngayon ng kulungan si Tony Hicks. 13 years na. But you know, there is a hope awaiting for Tony Hicks. There is a job waiting for him when he gets out of a prison because of Tariq's dad. Paglabas niya, may naghihintay na pag-asa ka sa kanya dahil bibigyan siya ng trabaho ng tatay ng kanyang pinatay. Sabi po sa Hebrews 12:15, see to it that no one misses the grace of God, and had that no bitter root grows up to cause trouble and defile many. And this is the good news to every one of us. Grace is available. Choose to forgive. Because forgiveness will boost up your energy to fight the battle of life. Your opponents, Satan, has no hold on you if you choose to forgive. Remember, forgiveness is a decision. Pains through forgiveness will leave a mark in you. Ulitin ko po, pains through forgiveness will leave a mark in you. And that is a stronger you and a mark of a champion. Let's pray. If you, this time, if you have offended God and if you have offended someone, 1 John 1:9 said, if you confess your sins to God, He is faithful and just to forgive you and to cleanse you from all your unrighteousness. You can ask for God's forgiveness right now. And also, you have the power in your hand to forgive yourself and to forgive others. Let us pray. Father, forgive us. Forgive me. I offended you many times by rejecting Jesus Christ and resisting to obey and to forgive me and cleanse me by the blood of Jesus Christ. And right now, I receive Jesus as my Lord and Savior. I choose to forgive myself as well. Breaking all the chains of the past. And now, I choose to forgive someone who hurted me. I take no hold of that person, and he or she takes no hold of me. We are both free. Parehas na po kaming malaya. Maraming salamat po sa kapatawaran. Maraming salamat din po sa ibinigay mo sa aking privilege para makapagpatawad. Thank you, Father, for your love. Thank you for your grace. And this is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. So congratulations po. If you choose to forgive, then you are now indeed free. Malaya ka na po sa anumang mga negative effect ng unforgiveness, ng bitterness or resentment. You are a free person. And now, you can advance and you can continue to fulfill your purpose and to achieve greater things because you are now have been set free. Maraming salamat po, Enjagians. Thank you sa pagsama nyo sa amin dito. At tomorrow, bukas po, meron po tayo ulit. The second word and the probably yung third, pagkakasyahin po natin yan until Saturday. May the Lord continue to bless us and continue to meditate and ponder on the message that we have received right now from the Word, from the Word of the Lord tonight. Thank you po and God bless. Good night, everyone.